Let's now talk about confirming and dating pregnancy. So here's a case. A 19-year-old presents to the emergency room with a complaint of nausea, vomiting, and right lower quadrant pain. She states the pain has become increasingly worse over the last 12 hours. She has no medical problems, no surgical history. She's never been pregnant. Her last menstrual period was 10 weeks ago, but she reports cycles are irregular. On physical exam, her vital signs are stable and she is afebrile. She is tender in the right lower quadrant on abdominal exam. On pelvic exam, there is no cervical motion tenderness, but she has fullness and tenderness in the right lower quadrant. What is the next best step in her management? A, ultrasound, B, urinary analysis, C, urine pregnancy tests, or D, serum pregnancy tests? Let's go through the lecture to figure out what the answer is. So there are several ways that we can confirm pregnancy and we can establish gestational age. We're going to talk about each of these and talk about the risks and the benefits and why one test is better than the other. So first of all, let's talk about last menstrual period. If we know a patient's last menstrual period and cycles are regular, we can determine the gestational age. And we use something called Nagel's rule. So what we do is we take the last menstrual period, subtract 3 months, and we add 7 days. So if a patient tells us her last menstrual period is April 1st, we subtract 3 months, giving us January, add 7 days, giving us the 8th, and we would know that her due date is January the 8th. Okay, again, this is based on an accurate last menstrual period. We can also confirm pregnancy through a urine pregnancy test. Now, the urine pregnancy test is a qualitative test. That means that it either tells us the patient is pregnant or the patient is not pregnant. So there's some benefits to that in that we can tell if a patient is pregnant, such as in our case that we discuss when we're trying to figure out what may be in our differential diagnosis, but this does not tell us how far along the pregnancy is. Next is a serum pregnancy test. Now this is a quantitative test. So this tells us exactly how much beta-HCG is in the blood. Different than the urine pregnancy test, if we remember, that one is qualitative, so it just says the patient is pregnant or the patient is not pregnant. With that serum test, because we can determine the amount of HCG, we can use that to help us with our ultrasound to determine if we should or should not see something in the uterus to help establish a gestational age. When the beta-HCG is at least 2,000, we should see something in the uterus on transvaginal ultrasound. When the beta-HCG is 6,000, we should be able to see something in the uterus on abdominal ultrasound. Speaking of ultrasound, this is the most accurate way to determine the gestational age. We expect with ultrasound in the first trimester that when we measure the fetus from the crown rump length, that it will be within 1 week of the last menstrual period. We'll talk about that in a little bit more detail as we go throughout this slide. This is a high yield amount of information, remembering how we confirm pregnancy and establish the gestational age using these four tests. So back to our patient. She's a 19-year-old presenting to the emergency room, again complaining of nausea, vomiting, right lower quadrant pain, and last menstrual period was about 10 weeks ago, and on exam, we feel some fullness on the right. Now, when we again think about those options of what we should do next, what do you think the answer is? Well, the answer is D. We want to do a serum pregnancy test. Remember that with the urine pregnancy test, this is qualitative. So this just tells us if the patient is pregnant or if the patient is not pregnant. That serum pregnancy test is more important because it actually tells us what the beta-HCG is so that when we do our ultrasound, we'll know if we should see something in the uterus or if it's too early. That helps us with our differential diagnosis.